Alhamdulillah, 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 alhamdulillah. Astaghfirullah, 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 الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تؤمن إليه. أسأل التوبة والمغفرة والهداية إنه هو التواب الرحيم. واغف عنا يا كريم، واغف عنا يا كريم، واغف عنا يا كريم، واغفر لنا بفضلك يا رحمن يا رحيم، يا ملك يا قدوس يا حافظ يا الله. الذي الله الاهل الله الظاهر الله الباطن الله هذه بشرك الله تعالى. واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله. الصلاه والسلام عليك يا رسول الله، الصلاه والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله، الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيد الأولين والآخرين. اشفعنا يا شفيع المرسلين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. قال الله تعالى في كتابه الحديث: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. كل يوم هو في شأن Allah Teala says in the Quran al-Kareem, every moment he, Allah Teala, is in a different state. Every moment What is a moment? A moment is now. It is indivisible. It's short. So Allah Ta'ala manifests Himself every moment in a different way. Time in Islam, in our religion, is an extremely important matter. No other religion, no other philosophy which I know of gives so much importance to time. Allah Ta'ala has divided the year into 12 months. Some of them you do certain things, some of them you are forbidden to do certain things. And in those 12 months, there is one blessed month, the month of Ramadan Sharif, during which, from a specific time to a specific time, we fast. At a specific time, we break fast. Specific time, we make certain prayers in addition to our normal prayers. In our lifetime, at a specific time of the year, we have to go to the Hajj. And at the Hajj, at specific times, we have to do certain duties. We have to move from Mecca to Mina, to Arafat, to Muzdalifah, back to Mina, and back to Mecca at specific times. A at specific times we have to pay our zakat. At specific times during the day we have to do our five times prayer. But how do we spend our time? We spend our time thinking what we are going to do tomorrow. Where are we going to go next summer? What are we going to do next year? And the year after that, and the year after that, and the year after that. We spend our time worrying, planning the future. And if any time is left to us, which we spend in thinking about the future, we use it about the past with nostalgia. How much better the past was, with regret the things which we should have done and which we haven't done. So the time for both of us is spent in the future, which does not exist, which we know nothing about, and all those plans which we are doing are based on things which we don't know if they will exist tomorrow, including ourselves. We don't know whether tomorrow or next summer or next year we will be on this world. But still, we spend effort and time thinking of the future. And then we sit and think of our memories of the past. None of these memories are really true. A few years back, somebody asked me to write my memoirs. If you are curious, it even exists in English. You can get one. And I did write it from birth till up to now. But I am absolutely sure, although I tried my best to not to lie, to really tell things as they were, I am sure if they are not all wrong, they are all not exactly right either. It doesn't occur to us that this moment when we, which is about a second, is the only reality, is the only truth right now. Neither the minute past or the minute to come. The moment, the now, is the essence of time. The now is the soul of time, which we never think of. We let it pass, become the past, and we wait for the next moment to come. Resulullah sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem says, do not ever curse the time. And the word which he uses there is dahr. Ya Imam, what is dahr in Arabic?
Dahr is the time, basically. It's the length of the time.
Aha. But what is the time ordinarily, which when we speak about?
Waqt.
Huh?
Waqt.
Yeah. So the word which he uses, do not curse the dahr. But that time is the moment which is stretches to before the before and to after the after. The infinite time. For he says, dahr is Allah. And Hazrat Ali Keramallahu Vechehu, when he used to pray his private prayers to Allah Ta'ala, he used to address him, Ya Dahar. Instead of Ya Rab, he used to address to Allah Ta'ala, Ya Dahar. If we lived the moment instead of trying to live in the future, which doesn't exist, instead of living in the past, which also doesn't exist because it's already gone, then Allah Ta'ala, Ya Dahar, perhaps will stretch that moment and it will affect our whole life as a human being, as a Muslim, and as a believer. I said that the now is the soul of the time. As we sit here, our soul inside of us is spread in all our physical being. It's as well at the tip of my finger, as well at the tip of my nose, as well at the top of my head, and at the end of my toe. So in the same manner, if we would be aware, if we would live the now, it is well capable of spreading all through our lives till we leave this world and even in the hereafter. If we burn our house, if we had a bag of gold, and if we would throw it into the water, or if we had a fortune that we throw it around, according to our religion, it is a sin. But some say, the greatest sin is to throw the time away. Because our lives are a series of breaths, are a series of moments, are a series of nows. 60 of them will make a minute. 60 of it will make an hour, 24 of it will make a day, 7 of it will make a week, 30 of it will make a month, and then the year, and then the century. But if you throw the moment away, it is like as if you have thrown centuries away. And some say that is the greatest sin. Yadda Har, all the creator of all, and all the creator of time, that you have created us and placed us on the face of this planet, and given us a span of life of certain number of breath and certain number of mouths. You have given us a mind, you have given us eyes to see, heart to feel with, ears to hear. Ya Rabbi, enable us and give us the heedfulness and ability to be conscious, an ability to be with you that moment, which is now, so that inshallah, that you will have mercy on us.
Amen.
And stretch that state of faithful, true servants of Allah at this moment will be stretched all through our lives.
Amen.
Amen. And all through our lives, before we even realize what we need, oh Lord, that you have given us what we need, and much more, so much more that we cannot possibly count. But the greatest of your gifts, that you have given us Iman, alhamdulillah, you have given us Islam, you have given us Islam. And you have given us your beloved, your first creation, our prophet, our guide, our example, our intercessor, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For all those gifts, O Lord, alas, we have been senseless. Shame on us, we have tyrannized ourselves. O Lord, forgive us and teach us thankfulness and count us amongst your thankful servants. And sometimes you test us. You test us, not that you know not, but so that we know whether we are truly faithful, whether truly obedient, whether we truly love you. You test us with little pain, little sickness, little poverty, little hunger, never above our forbearance. And you praise patience as a way to pass those tests. You say patience is half of religion. You say patience is the key to paradise. Patience is the key to success in this world. And Ya Rab, we don't know what patience is. We are impatient. We complain about you when we are tested. We complain about you to the doctors and to the lawyers and to our wives and to our friends. Oh Lord, we have tyrannized ourselves. Ya Rabbi, forgive us for our impatience and teach us patience and count us amongst your patient servants. Ya Wahid, Ya Ahad, you say hold on to the rope of Islam and do not separate yourselves from each other. Your beloved Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says every Muslim is a brother to every Muslim. He says that his Ummah is but one nation. He says that the Muslim, that all the Muslims is like one single body. If the finger of that body aches, that the whole body aches. And he says that if we do not love each other for Allah's sake, our faith is incomplete. We know all this, and we do none of it. 1,600,000,000 of us are all shattered, and we are only by ourselves. We don't care for each other, we don't love each other. In fact, we hate each other and we kill each other. But once, oh Lord, we were all together and we were united. And we were all together and we were united, we were beautiful, and we were strong, and we were wise, and all and everybody envied us, and copied us, and even loved us, and even feared us. Look at us today, O Lord, and have mercy on Ummat Muhammad.
Amen.
Ya Rabbi, bring back the unity amongst the Ummat Muhammad. Bring back the unity which is the right of the Ummat Muhammad.
Amen.
Bring back the wisdom and bring back the strength.
Amen.
Back to the Ummat Muhammad.
Amen.
We permit the Sayyidah al-Mushadim Taha al-Yatim. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad al-Maqrib al-Balawan. Fataqab al-Asaran. فكرر الجديدان واستكمل الفرقدان فبلغ بروحاه ارواح اهل بيته من الطيات والسلام تبارك وسلم عليه كثيرا 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 فصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى جميع الانبياء والمرسلين والابرياء والصالحين وعلى ملائكتك والمقربين وعلى اهل طاعتك اجمعين من السماوات والارضين ورضوان الله تعالى على ال رسول الله واصحابه اجمعين امين والحمد لله.